Hello everyone, and welcome to the Lab 5 help session for Stoplight. In this help session, I'm going to cover how to get started and how to control all the different lights necessary for this project. So the first thing you really need to know is that we're not building an intersection traffic light, we're building a pedestrian stoplight. So there's a two-lane road with a crosswalk. There are not cars going in both directions. The red light is just to give pedestrians time to cross. The first thing we need to do is our systematic decomposition. So we're going to write out in English every line that we might need for our program. So the first thing we need to do is initialize all the lights that we're going to use. So we're going to initialize the lights we're going to use for the car, the lights we're going to use for the pedestrians, and the switches. And the first thing we're going to do is turn off all the lights so we don't have garbage in those values. We don't want any of the lights on that aren't supposed to be, so if we can just turn them all off, we'll know that we're starting from a clean slate. Then for the state one, the first thing we're going to do is turn on the green and pedestrian lights, and then we're going to delay for 20 seconds. After the 20 seconds is up, we'll move on to the yellow state, so we have to turn off the green light, turn on the yellow light, and the pedestrian light's already on, so we can leave that. Then we delay for 5 seconds. If no button has been pressed, then we go into red state 3, so we need to turn off the yellow light, turn on the red light, and delay 5 seconds. And we'll figure out how to do that if statement in a minute. So if a button has been pressed, turn off the yellow light, turn off the orange light, because the orange light turns on when a button is pressed, turn on the red light, and then we have to turn on the pedestrian green light and delay 5 seconds. And after it's delayed 5 seconds, it's going to toggle on and off for every second. So I'm going to create kind of a pseudocode loop here for how that would work. We want to toggle the pedestrian green light. It's going to be easiest. We can just toggle it since it's supposed to be on and off for the same interval of time. And then we want to delay 1 second before we toggle it again. And then we have to decrement our counter for the number of times it's going to toggle. So we want it to have a counter that'll result in 6 toggles. And then we'll jump back to the beginning of that loop, toggle it, delay, decrement. And when it's done doing that loop, it'll fall into the 5th second toggle, and the loop structure for this is going to be pretty similar. You'll just have a different delay length and a different number of loops. So after that's done, we want to jump back to our green state 1, because the pedestrian case will have been handled. So now we've got our basic layout for how the program needs to work. So let's go in. So let's start creating more detail off of this. So we've got a bunch of lines that are just delay for 2 seconds. So let's create a delay loop that will, that we can call from all those sections where we just want to delay. So let's use register 15 as our counter. So the first thing we're going to need to do is decrement R15 and then jump if not equal back to delay. So that works just like every other loop. And then it has to be a subroutine, so we're going to return at the end of that. Now, sometime in our program, we need to pull the switches and see if it's been pressed. And since delay runs most of the time in our program, we probably want to check the switches in here. So that way it's constantly checking if the switches have been pressed, because they don't maintain their pressed value very long. So if the switches have been pressed, we need to turn on the orange LED, so we can also do that here. Now, we'll actually be able to test the bits for the orange light to see if the switch has been pressed. So that's the only marker we need if a switch has been pressed. I'll talk about how that works later. So now the next hurdle we really need to jump is to figure out how to turn the lights on. So I've got the picture from traffic.asm of the different ports on our board. And if you look at port 4, you can see that the four car LEDs are port 4.0 through port 4.3. So those ports, port 4 is an 8-bit number in memory, and each of those bits controls a different thing. So if you want to turn on LED 1, you put a 1 in the first bit, because that's the first bit on port 4. So we're going to use the hex representations of those. So the first line I typed up there doesn't have any of the lights on. The second one has the green car light on. The third one has the yellow light on. And that one has the red pedestrian light and the green car light on. So in order to initialize all the car lights at once, we're going to bit set O by OF, because hex F is for 1s, so that's putting a 1 in all of the car LEDs. I actually have a bit of a syntax error there. There needs to be a pound sign in front of that OXOF for it to work correctly. And then AND P for DIR. This says you're going to set the bit in the memory location associated with port 4, and then the DIR says you're setting the direction of the bits, so it's whether it's input or output. On our next line of our pseudocode, it says we need to initialize the pedestrian lights. So that's LED 6 and LED 5, and those are located on point 4.6 and port 3.4. So you can use the same method to get those to initialize. Initializing the switches is a little more complicated because it's an input source. Dr. Roper has a bunch of code in the lab specifications on how you can set that up for polling or interrupts. So I'm going to look at that here. He's got the setup and code for polling. So now we're going to turn off all the car lights. So we want a bit clear, because 0 means off. We're going to bit clear OXOF, because that'll access all of the car lights at once. And we're going to go to AND P4 out. That says whether the light is on or off. So you only use DIR once at the top of your program to initialize, in this case, but you'll use P4 out to toggle the switches on or off. So let's figure out how to check our switches. So we're going to put this code in here. Now, what this code is doing, it moves the contents of P1 in and R13, so it's grabbing what the values of the switches are and throwing it in R13, and then it's ANDing it with OF, because the switches are on the first 4 bits, and the value of a pressed switch is actually low. So when you AND it, and then XOR it, it basically reverses it so that the pressed switches are high in R13. So those are ones. And that way it's easier for us to do jumps. So this is the command that you'll use to test your orange LED. So you just fill in the blanks. And then after that, you'll have a jump based on the result. So you can find more about that instruction in your MSP430 Family User's Guide that was in your readings. So let's talk about how to generate a simple delay all off of 1/10 of a second subroutine. So we're going to need a loop. So the first thing we want to do is call delay, and that'll give us 1/10 of a second. Then we're going to decrement a counter, so let's use R14. And then we're going to need to jump, if not equal, back to loop 1. So it'll delay 1/10 of a second, decrement the counter, and jump. So our counter, R14, is going to hold the number of times the loop will have to run to equal a second. So 1/10 of a second, or 20 seconds divided by 1/10 of a second, you're going to need to call that subroutine 200 times. So let's talk about ways of controlling the light for this loop here. We're going to want to use an XOR to toggle, because the XOR command will, if it's on, it'll turn it off, and if it's off, it'll turn it on. And then we will have a 1 second delay loop, and that 1 second delay loop is going to work just like the loop up at the top we just did. So we have a call delay set after a label, and a counter decremented, and a jump back to that label. But then after it gets out of that loop, it's going to decrement the 6 counter, jump back up, toggle the light again, and do that loop again. So at the end, you end up having light toggles, it delays for a second, and it toggles again, delays again, and it'll do that 6 times. And then when all of that is done, it will fall into the 5th second toggle. And I'll let you guys write that. So that's the Lab 5 help session. I hope you guys have an idea of where to start and how to go about doing this lab. If you have any questions, you can always come to the TAs for help. And as one of my 235 TAs once said, and I still think it's hilarious, back to your regularly scheduled programming.